Welcome to Evangelistic Outreach Ministries.
The fields are white, all ready to harvest.
For over half a century, the Evangelistic Outreach team has traveled across the street, about the nation, and around the world with the gospel message. We're dedicated to the vision of our late founder, Dr. Calvin Evans, to reach the unreached for Jesus Christ. May the love of Christ touch you, and may His Word teach you today on Evangelistic Outreach.
Well, it's simply hard to believe we're at the end of the month of September, and we thank you for your prayers. It's been a very busy month, but God has certainly showered us with His blessings. We've been traveling many miles and a lot of meetings, and this week will be no exception. Calvary will be headed to the Canaanland Free Will Baptist Church in Grove City, Ohio. We'll tell you more about that great camp meeting here in just a moment. But we ask that you would join us in prayer today as we ask God's blessings over this broadcast. Father, we love you today. We thank you for your goodness to us. Lord, it's just simply amazing to us how that on a daily basis it seems like we meet new people or we receive letters and hearing from folks that were touched or blessed or encouraged. The newsletters the last few months, we've received people that have needed help with grieving and how they've been able to cope with through the grace of Jesus Christ with the special messages we've been sending out. And Lord, we thank you for that opportunity. Lord, I ask that you would bless this program today. You know who's watching and you know who's listening. And I pray that someone there that is today that is tuning in would be touched and blessed, and especially if they don't know you as their personal Savior, I pray that they realize that there is there's a change that can happen. They can have a better life through your Son, Jesus Christ. Bless us today, we pray, and we'll praise you for it all. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, we hope this number and song is a blessing to you today.
Answer prayers here tonight, Lord, in Jesus' name. I felt the ache of emptiness this world could not relieve. My heart has lived in poverty that no one else could see. Until I found the sweet restoring stream that changed my life. He called to me, come and drink, and my need was satisfied. My God will for the longings of my soul, He alone can fill my cup till my spirit overflows. From a well of living water, He renews me with His love. Will always be enough. Tomorrow I could rise to find that everything has changed. This way of faith could take me to some unexpected place, but in all the twists and turns of life, I'm sure of this one thing, where the road seems so uncertain, my God will come. with me. My God will always be enough for the longings of my soul. He alone till my spirit overflows from a well of living water. He renews me with his love. My God will always be.
As we mentioned, this is the last Sunday of September, so this will be the last week we'll be mentioning this month's free gift offer entitled Many Crowns. The last 2 weeks we've been sharing with you the message of that same title from Calvin Ray Evans, preached from the Spring Jubilee, but also included on that free gift offer, a special singing from Karen Peck and New River, as well as the Spring Jubilee Choir. And then we also have an added bonus message that we'll be sharing with you today entitled Build an Ark, and that was preached from myself there at the Spring Jubilee. We've sent out hundreds of these this month, but you can still call us this week to receive your free copy. It's available on DVD or audio CD, again, free of charge. We just simply need to know that you would like to have a free copy. So when calling us this week, make sure you mention that. Let us know which format you prefer, and we'll get it right out to you. I'll give the contact information here in just a little bit. But Calvary will be headed to Columbus, Ohio on Monday evening at 7 p.m. to be with our dear friends at the Canaanland Free Will Baptist Church in Grove City, Ohio. The church is located on the corner of Home and Gantz Road in Grove City. Sean Beauchamp is the pastor there, and we absolutely love to be a part of this great camp meeting. We have great preachers in all week long, and but Calvary will be there on Monday evening beginning at 7 p.m. Fantastic singing, just a spirit of worship unlike any other through the year. So if you would like to be a part of that, or maybe you need more information or directions, please feel free to give us a call. Our contact information, 1-800-767-8713. You may also visit us online at calvinevans.org, or if you would need to reach us by mail, you can do that as well. Our mailing address, 299 Ohio Avenue, New Boston, Ohio, 45662. Thank you for what you're doing and praying for this ministry. Thank you for the support and prayers that you're giving to the people in Texas that we've been trying to help as a result of the Hurricane Harvey. And thank you for all that you're doing. And believe me, we are doing our best to make sure that people there are helped. And we are just, it's amazing to see God's people coming together in unity to help those that are in need. And thank you in advance for what you're going to do and for what you have already done. And we want to go to the message as an extra bonus sermon on this month's free gift offer. It's entitled Build an Ark. I was able to preach it and how we need to do our best to build an ark for the safety of our family and our friends and for our future. We hope the message is a challenge and a blessing to you today. The Bible says in the book of Exodus, chapter 2,
verses 1 through 3. And there went a man of the house of Levi and took to wife a daughter of Levi. And the woman conceived and bare a son. And when she saw him that he was a goodly child, she hid him 3 months. And when she could no longer hide him, she took for him an ark of bulrushes and daubed it with slime and with pitch and put the child therein, and she laid it in the flags by the river's brink. Tonight, I think we all could agree that the greatest institution that God ever created is the home. Family. I think we can say this as well, that so goes the home, so goes the nation. As the home goes, so the church goes. As the home goes, so does the community, etc., etc. And I think so many times we have made the mistake. Now hear me out while I'm about ready to say, but the Lord showed me something a few weeks ago, and I believe I'm correct in what I'm about ready to say. We've made the mistake by saying that Satan is attacking the church. But hear me out for a moment. Do you believe Satan knows the word of God? Jesus said himself, upon this rock, I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. Satan's not attacking the church because he can't touch the church. He can't touch the church of the living God. The gates of hell shall not prevail against it. Listen, there is no demon in hell that can stop the church of the living God. The blood-bought, the redeemed, the church, Satan cannot touch it. Can you say amen? He cannot touch it. But what he tries to do to get inside the church is to destroy the family. He attacks it indirectly. And he's using many different devices to attack marriages, to destroy our children, and to destroy the very foundation of our country and our churches, and that is the home. I think we all can agree tonight that families look a lot different than they did even 10, 20, 30 years ago. And before I go any further, I'm not condemning anyone's family situation or how they was raised. I'm just simply stating that we must learn that God has given us valuable possessions in our family and in our home, and we must do everything we can to protect those possessions that God has given us. And you say, Brian, how do we do that? We do what Jochebed did here in the book of Exodus. She built an ark. That's the title of my message tonight, Building an Ark. First of all, I want you to notice we need to build an ark tonight for our family. We need to build an ark for our family. Jochebed built an ark of bulrushes to protect her son. His name was Moses. Now, I don't know if you know very much about where she laid him in. I know the ark of bulrushes was made out of these plants called papyrus, and she laid him in the river. And we have to understand this was the Nile River. And when you begin to study the Nile River, you begin to understand that the Nile River is infested with crocodiles. And in fact, there's a whole section in National Geographic just devoted to Nile crocodiles. In fact, they're different than North American crocodiles. They're a lot more vicious and a lot more, they're predators. In fact, they're ambush predators. Did you know Nile crocodiles can wait for hours, days, and even weeks for one moment of attack? They can live up to 100 years. Some of them gain 23 feet in length. They have powerful jaws. But listen to this. Their jaws aren't used for eating. Their jaws are used to hold down their prey, to twist them, to drown them, and then ultimately pull them apart. Where you see one crocodile, there'll be more waiting in the wings to come and attack. Doesn't that sound like the enemy of our soul, Satan? Satan is the deceiver. He will use anything he can. He'll wait for days, moments, even weeks for one moment of attack when you slip up. At a moment of weakness, at a moment of temptation, Satan will be there to attack us and to attack our family. Think about this. As I was comparing this to Satan and the enemies against our soul, the powerful jaws to hold down their prey, to rip them apart. That's what Satan wants us to do. He comes to attack our home, to rip us apart. He wants to rip marriages apart. He wants to rip families apart. And let's guess what? He's doing a really good job at it. They can hunt on land and water. They reach top speeds that many of their prey cannot elude from. So she had this problem that she was laying her son in this ark of bulrushes and letting him go in the midst of these vicious crocodiles. The other problem she had was a spiritual crocodile. His name was Pharaoh. Pharaoh was on the throne, and if you read in Exodus chapter 1, you'll find that he gave a decree. Here's what he said to do. I want you to take the baby boys and I want you to throw them into the river. That river was the Nile River. He said, I want you to take all the baby boys and throw them in the river. And the Bible says that she hid her son for 3 months because she was afraid of what the Pharaoh was going to do. Do you realize this, that the book of Ezekiel says that the Pharaoh is the great dragon that lies in the midst of the river? The Pharaoh is referred to as the crocodile that lies in the midst of the Nile River. So not only was she worried about these crocodiles that physically that she was trying to protect her child from, but here all these, the spiritual crocodile was coming at her by the name of Pharaoh. She hid her baby boy for 3 months. And here's what I got to thinking, and it was many months ago that the Lord allowed us to be in a group of preachers, and this preacher began to tell us, and he actually asked the question to us, me and Calvin Ray. He said, have you studied about crocodiles? And I said, no. And so he gave us a few things, and I began to research it for myself, and I found some interesting things about these crocodiles and about these bulrushes. She made these ark of bulrushes, and it's actually a papyrus plant. And what got me is, how in the world could she willingly let her son float down the Nile River in a basket of weeds, knowing that the crocodiles were no match, that the bulrushes were no match for a crocodile? Now that's a question that maybe you never thought of, but I thought of it. And I know that his sister Miriam was on the river's brink and watching where he would end up, but Miriam was a young girl. There's no way that she could protect him from vicious crocodiles. So what's the answer? The answer is found in the ark that she built. According to a botanical site out of the UK, it says that crocodiles will not go around bulrushes because bulrushes are abhorrent to crocodiles, quoting the website, meaning that crocodiles won't get around bulrushes because they are disgusted by them. It's kind of like planting certain flowers around certain things. Like I heard marigolds, that deer won't eat marigolds. So people plant marigolds around certain things so the deer won't eat them and get into their garden, certain things like that. Well, listen, that's the way it was with crocodiles. Crocodiles weren't going to get around these bulrushes because they didn't like them. They were disgusted by them. So she knew she could willingly let her son go into that Nile River and be protected from the crocodile, because she knew, thank God, that God was going to protect him. Not only was she going to be protected by these bulrushes that she made, but the Bible says, and I read it to you tonight, that she daubed it with slime and with pitch. And that blesses me right there, because that same word is the same pitch that Noah used to get on the ark on the inside and on the outside. And it's the same word that you find in Leviticus 17:11. For the life of the flesh is in the blood. And I have given it to you upon the altar to make a sacrifice for your soul. For it is the blood that maketh an atonement for the soul. That word atonement is the same word in here that means pitch. Not only did she cover him with her prayers, but thank God she covered him with the blood. Aren't you thankful tonight? Woo! Glory to God! Hallelujah! I've got one responsibility upon this earth. I got a 17-year-old daughter, and I got a 12-year-old son, and my greatest responsibility is to ensure that they are protected, that I build an ark for them, that I can willingly let them go out into this world knowing they'll be protected. Why? Because I built an ark. I built an ark. I built an ark. I built an ark for my family. Hallelujah. Don't you know the Bible says that the angel of the Lord encampeth around about them that fear him and keep him. And as long as we ensure that we do our best and train our children in the way that should go, the Bible says it will not depart. I believe every Sunday school lesson that my son and my daughters ever learn. I believe every junior church lesson they've ever learned from Miss Carol. I believe every sermon they've ever heard, every song they've ever said under. I believe if God forbid, if they ever should go astray, when they lay their head down at night, they'll remember each song, they'll remember each sermon, they'll remember what mommy and daddy taught them. I'm telling you, it's our responsibility, parents. If you have children tonight, that's your main responsibility, is to build an ark to ensure that your son and daughter are protected from this world. The vicious crocodiles are out there to get them, and we must do all that we can to protect them. And we need to shelter them as much as we can. I know one of these days I'm going to have to let them go. Our pastor preached Sunday at our home church. Calvin Ray said, when we get to the point where we can let them go and know that God's taken over, then we know that we've instilled in them the right things. And we know that God's going to be with them. We need to build an ark for our family. Can you say amen? Amen? Secondly, we need to build an ark for our friends. We see revivals that are happening all across this country. And people ask, they've asked us. And I've asked myself, how in the world could these things happen? We used to hear of 8, 9, 12 week revivals years ago. But we hadn't heard about much of them anymore till the last couple of years. And how they're springing up, and even here in our own community, we have churches here tonight that broke out in revival, people being saved. You say, Brian, what's the common factor? I'll tell you what the common factor is. It's people that are burdened for their friends. It's people that are burdened for revival. People getting old-fashioned, yearning for the Holy Ghost to move. They fast, they pray, they seek the face of God, and they're burdened for their friends to be saved. They say, Lord, whatever it takes, if it makes me sick, whatever it does, I want to see them go to heaven. Oh, that's what we're missing today, church. We're not building an ark for our friends. We're not doing enough to ensure that they come to Jesus Christ. Oh, we may write them down on a list somewhere, but listen, what have you done to let them know that you love them and care for them? We're worried about sending them to hell, but listen, you can't scare them off to hell number two. It's your responsibility to let them know that you love them and care for them. And bless God, there is a God in heaven that loves them and wants to save them. We need to build an ark for our friends. Many of you know, and many of you are affected by the awful drug epidemic that is plaguing our nation and plaguing our state and our community. Within our own county, if I got the numbers right, I apologize if I don't, but I believe last month over 200 overdoses just right here in our own county. And it's getting worse. And some people will just write it off and say, well, it's the end of time. That's the way the world's supposed to be. You can go ahead and die in your seat. I'm going to try to have a passion and a burden for the people. God bless you that are working with those that are drug addicted. God bless you, counselor, that are there trying to help them get off this awful mess. I know it's going to take the power of God to do it. And I pray for them on a daily basis, because we've never seen nothing like we're seeing now, how it affects our people. In fact, there's a drug that's coming over from Siberia. The name of it is called crocodile. And it's the most severe drug you've ever heard of. And I don't know all the ingredients, but I know two main ones are paint thinner and gasoline. And they burn this down, and they put it into their arms, and they inject it, and it eats the flesh from the inside out. You say, Brian, that doesn't happen here in America. Oh, yes, it does. And before you know it, it'll make its way right up the tri-state area. I'm telling you, folks, it's here. And we're dumb if we think we can just let it go and pass us by. Wake up, church. We need to have a burden for our friends. You've got a great opportunity this week to help the children of those people that are addicted to these drugs. The children are innocent. They can't do anything about the way their mom and dad's doing. And you have a wonderful opportunity to help those kids in need this week. Next door, you have places where you can drop off toothpaste and personal hygiene items. And listen, it breaks our heart to hear the stories of these kids that are in foster care and there's not enough parents to take care of them. There are dozens and dozens of them that have no place to go because of this terrible drug epidemic. Folks, listen, the responsibility is on us. I know that they've made bad decisions and I know the devil's got a grasp on them. But listen, it's time for us to wake up. It's time for us to get a burden and build an ark for our friends. Amen. We need to build an ark for our friends. We need to build an ark for our family. We need to build an ark for our faith. We do. Our faith is under attack like it's never been before. The so-called, quote-unquote, normal people in this country think that we're weird. We do. They think everything should be handed on a silver platter to them without doing nothing for it. Amen. And then they attack us for standing up for freedoms and faith. I'm telling you. They call us idiots, they call us crazy, they call us stupid. And our faith is under attack. And now more than ever, we need to build an ark for our faith, to protect our faith. You say, Brian, how is that done? It's simple. The Bible says faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. If we're going to make it in this world and we're going to make it till Jesus comes back, we have to have a word of God with us on a daily basis. I'm telling you, it's important to have the word of God. You say, Brian, how do we build an ark of faith? I'll tell you how. It was instilled in my life many, many years ago, even before I was born. Here's how you build an ark of faith. You take Bibles from your great-grandparents right here. And you take Bibles from your mommy and your daddy and your grandpa and mom and dad. That's how you build an ark right there, with the word of God. It was passed down from generation to generation to generation. And I could put my Bible on top of that. And I could get my son's Bible and my daughter's Bible. And I could put it on top of that. And it goes back further. I'm telling you, that's where we find our foundation, is when it's built on the word of God.
And we come to the close of another week of broadcasting. Thank you for joining us. I hope that you will plan to join me if you're near Columbus, Ohio on this coming Monday night. I'll be there at the Canaan Land Free Will Baptist Church, where Sean Beauchamp is the pastor. Service time is 7 o'clock. Help us pack out the big sanctuary there at the Canaan Land Free Will Baptist Church in Grove City, Ohio. I love being able to worship together with you. Till next week at this same time, may God bless you and yours.
Thank you for joining us today on Evangelistic Outreach Ministries.
The fields are white, all ready to harvest.
For more information about this ministry, contact us at Evangelistic Outreach Ministries, 299 Ohio Avenue, New Boston, Ohio, 45662, or toll free at 800-767-8713. You can also visit us online at calvinevans.org.